الحمد لله الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ونبينا وشفيعنا وحبيبنا وطبيبنا وملجانا ومولانا محمد صلى الله تعالى عليه وسلم وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. An important arcan in Islam is, and sometimes very neglected at times, is the concept of zakat. To speak about the shara aspect of it, the mechanics and so forth, I would leave that a bit aside. I would like to speak to you on another dimension, as Imam Ghazali rahmatullah alayhi so beautifully expounds the purpose and significance of zakat. We have to understand the necessity of paying zakat, how it represents a test of our character, and why it has been made one of the fundamental principles of Islam. Even though it is a financial transaction and has not a physical aspect of ibadah, but we need to understand and look at 3 points here. Testing the degree of love of Allah. That's the first one we should look at. When we say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, it is an obligatory, it is a wajib affirmation of the divine unity and testimony to the singleness, the wahdaniyya, to whom we worship. Complete fulfillment of this obligation requires us that the one who affirms the divine unity should direct his love to none but the one who is unique, Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. There is little value in a mere verbal talking or affirmation. Shahadu an la ilaha illallah, shahadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, shahadu an la ilaha illallah, shahadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah. Allah is not asking for that. The degree of love is tested only by separating the lover from the other things he loves. In our eyes, worldly goods are an object of love in everybody's eyes, being the means by which one enjoys the benefit of this world. And there's nothing wrong with it. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنًا. We ask our sustainer, oh Allah, give us the good and the best things in this world. But we balance it. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنًا. And also the good in the hereafter. But because of these worldly things, we become attached to it. And we shy away even from maut. We shy away from death. Even though death leads us to the most beloved, Allah Jalla Jalaluhu. So the truth of our claim to love Allah is therefore put to a test. And we are asked to give up our wealth, which is in our sight all the time. That's why Allah so beautifully says in the Quran, بَعْدَ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ اشْتَرَى مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَمْوَالَهُمْ بِأَنَّ لَهُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Subhanallah. Verily Allah has purchased and made a transaction with the believers, with their lives and their properties, their wealth, whatever they might have. For what? And themselves, anfusahum and amwaluhum. For what? To exchange it for Jannah, for paradise. What an amazing transaction Allah is giving to us. Subhanallah. And Allah also says that true piety, piousness, means to give one's money away, or one's wealth away, in spite of our love of it. لَيْسَ الْبِرْ أَن تُوَلُّوا هُجُوهَكُمْ قِبْلَ الْمَشْرِقِ وَالْمَغْرِبِ Piety does not mean that you must turn your face towards east or west or towards Qibla, as what Allah has mentioned. ولكن البر من آمن بالله واليوم الآخر والملائكة والكتاب والنبيين. But piety means the one who believes in Allah, the last day, the angels, the book, the prophets. وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى. سبحان الله. Here's the punchline. وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى. And he gives his wealth in spite of love for it to his family. Look at the proportions Allah's talking about, our priorities, how we give. وآتى المال على حبه ذوي القربى واليتامى والمساكين وابن السبيل والسائلين وفي الرقاب وأقام الصلاة وآتى الزكاة. سبحان الله. Allah says, you give your money despite your love, despite you loving it, you first give to your family, then to the orphans, then to the poor, the masakin, then to the wayfarer who's on the way, stranded, and to those who ask, and to set slaves free, and those who perform salah, and gives the zakat, subhanAllah. وَالْمُوفُونَ بِعَهْدِهِمْ إِلَىٰ عَهَدُ. And who fulfills the covenant when they make it. We must be a nation of our word. Do not keep something and say something, I'll meet you there inshallah 2 o'clock, and you don't come. Sometimes we're human, we make mistakes. Or you're going to give so much, or you're going to give this, or you're going to give that. Don't break your word, break your neck. وَالصَّابِرِينَ فِي الْبَأْسَاءِ وَالْدَرَّاءِ وَحِينَ الْبَأْسِ. And who are patient, says Allah, in the tribulations and the adversity and in the time of stress. أُولَٰئِكَ الَّذِينَ صَبَرُوا وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُتَّقُونَ. Such are the people of the truth, and they are al-muttaqun. Another dimension of zakat is to remove and eliminate miserliness, to be a bakhil, a stingy person. And hence Allah, Jalla Jalalahu, is forcing us to part with certain amounts. Although it is a measly 2.5%. So the divine decree by which Allah bids his servant to spend his wealth is also significant in destroying the habit of being stingy. وَمَنْ يُوقَ شُحَّ نَفْسِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُفْلِحُونَ. And whoever is saved from his insatiable desire for wealth, such are they who will be successful, says Allah in the Quran. And this habit of stinginess and miserliness is destroyed. The purity, the one acquires, subhanAllah, is in proportion to your expenditure, to your delight in giving away, and to one's joy in spending for the sake of Allah. That is our way, our motto, how we should be giving. Don't say, Ya Allah, salviya zakat. No. Astaghfirullah. Ya Allah, salviya jumaa mufriya fa imam khasad wa lilibun. Salviya moan and groan, complain. Some job. We have to. You as fathers and mothers, says Allah to you, وَأْمُرْ أَهْلَكَ بِالصَّلَاةِ. You order your household to make salah. وَاسْتَبِرْ عَلَيْهَا. And nag on them. You make salah? Yes. When? Subuh. I want the subuh. Subuh is missing in the quran. We also acquire an expression of gratitude when we give zakah. And we also have to pay our zakat at the proper time. It is good practice to anticipate the moment when payment is due. And the Shara tells us Ramadan and Muharram are the best times to take up. We're not limited. But the Shara tells us in Ramadan and in Muharram. We have just passed Muharram, we suffer already. This then demonstrates the willingness to comply by bringing joy to the hearts of the poor. They are anticipating, because they are waiting their heart, not your heart. It's from Allah. Coming through to you, to them is theirs. And if you forestall it, Allah might place obstacles in the places of you. So be careful. Whenever the impulse to good arises within you, brothers and sisters, if it arises from within, you must grasp that opportunity. For Allah, for the hadith says, once the believer heart lies between the two fingers of Allah. Of course, Allah has no fingers. It's because we are fickle. That is what we are talking about here. We might change our minds. And shaitan threatens poverty and bids us to commit atrocious things because of that. So we delay. No, inshallah. No, there's all sorts of excuses. And this demonic suggestion, this satanic suggestion, follows quickly on the angelic inspiration. We know we must do it. This feeling of we have to give zakat, that's angelic. But now can shaitan, mahubichi. This must be very careful. We are also asked to give in secret. It's important to give in secret, for it removes our hypocrisy from us. This display of hypocrisy we want to give. For Allah says, in tuktus sadaqat fati'immahi. If you disclose your sadaqat, it is okay. Wa in tukfuha wa tu'tuha al-fuqara fa huwa khairun lakum. But if you conceal it and give it to the poor, it is better for you. Wa yukaffir ankum min sayyi'atikum wallahu bima ta'maluna khabir. Allah will forgive you your sins, and Allah is well acquainted with what you do. Allah speaks about, the hadith says, Nabi alayhi salam, that seven people will be under the shade on the day of Yawm al-Qiyamah, under the throne. You know, when we make wudu, you know, we make wudu very quickly. We've been taught to make wudu a long way. For each part, you have a dua. When you wash your hands, for your arms, for example, Allahumma la a'tini kitabi bi yamini wa hasibni hisaba yasira. Oh Allah, give me the kitab in my right hand, the good kitab. Allahumma la tu'tini kitabi bi shimali. Oh Allah, don't give me the kitab in my left hand. So we speak about the shade, we wash our foreheads and our heads. We say, Allahumma inni tahta dhil. Oh Allah, let me be under your shade. Tahta dhil li arshik, of your arsh. Yawma la dhilla illa dhilla. On that day where there will be no shade except your shade, under your arsh, illa dhilla arshika ya Allah. So when we wash our forehead, we know what we are talking about. Here the hadith says, seven people will be under the shade. A just ruler. Number two, a young person who worships Almighty Allah. Number three, a person whose heart is attached to the masjid. Number four, two people who love Allah for the sake of Allah and who come together and part for the sake of Allah. Subhanallah, Allah makes us of those. Number five, a man who is called by a beautiful woman of a good family but refuses her. And he says, Inni akhafullah. I am afraid of Allah. Number six, a person who gives money in charity so secretly that his left hand doesn't know what his right hand does. And number seven, someone who remembers Allah. Who remembers Allah, dhikrullah, so privately that his eyes brim with tears. May Allah make us all. It's been said by the scholars, three things are accounted among the treasures of righteousness when you give sadaqah and zakat. Whenever fame is the donor's objective, his work will be in vain. Since the purpose of giving sadaqah and zakat is to eliminate the stinginess and to weaken the love of wealth. But the love of status has a strong hold over the ruh. That's why it's called nafs. When our ruh is placed within us and our flesh and skin is clothing, it become nafs. It's only when it's purified, when zakah also means to purify, then your nafs becomes ruh. And you have different stages of ruh, or your nafs rather. And the highest stage is when it is addressed, Ya ayyatuha nafsul mutmainna, irji'i ila rabbika radiyatan mardiyah. That nafs which has reached a level of mutma'inna, contentment, itminan, return to me. Our nafs at the moment is below our neighbor. Nafsul ammara bisu, as Allah explains in the Quran. The
bestial, the animal nafs that is controlling us. There are different grades, inshallah. Allah wants to speak about a different nafs from another time. We also have to give openly. Why? So we encourage one another. That's the sole purpose. وَتَعَوَلُوا عَلَى الْبَرِّ وَالتَّقْوَى. That's all we do. And we also have to avoid taunting and hurting one another. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَا تُبْطِلُوا صَدَقَاتِكُمْ بِالْمَنِّ وَالْأَذَى كَالَّذِي يُنْفِقُ مَالَهُ رِئَاءَ النَّاسِ. Oh, you who believe, do not render in vain your charity by reminders of your generosity or by injury, says Allah, like him who spends his wealth to be seen by Allah. Be very careful. Allah protect us from that, ya Allah. One should therefore realize that giving alms, giving sadaqat, giving zakat is actually paying Allah what is due, while the poor person is actually receiving his rizq from Allah. Anyone who grasps the significance of the 3 points realizes that he is only a benefactor to himself. To demonstrate his love for Allah and to get rid from himself or herself the miserliness, and to give thanks for the blessings of the wealth which Allah has given in hope of receiving more and giving more. Ameen. We also have to adopt humility. You must understand, my brothers and sisters, that 2.5% is a tiny fraction. And to pay only this, to content oneself with the least generous level of expenses, as we have explained before. It reminds me of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu. One of the categories of giving zakat, as you know, is fi sabilillah, jihad fi sabilillah, on the way to Allah. When the call was made for zakat by Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Sayyidina Umar thought, I'm going to beat Sayyidina Abu Bakr this time. Because every time he comes to do good, he outstrips me way ahead. So I'm going to give half of my estate to Allah and His Rasul. But of course, when Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq was already there, radiallahu anhu, and he gave everything. His zakat was 100%. One of the pious people was asked the question, what is the percentage of zakat that we have to give? And the pious man said, are you speaking about the point of shara or the point of your nafs? The man became crazy. Say, what have you got another percentage you're talking about here? Where is this? Where have you come with this new concept? He says, if you're speaking about 2.5%, it is enough. That is what the shara commands. But if you speak about Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, then your percentage is 100%. By giving yourself and everything. And when Sayyidina Abu Bakr was asked radiallahu anhu, what have you left for your family? Allah and His Rasul. Look at that yaqeen, look at that love, subhanAllah. You must understand that wealth belongs to Allah. And He would prefer to see us give everything if we can. He has not commanded so. It is only because He knows our situation, we will be heartless. That is the reason. For Allah says, إِيَسْأَلْكُمُوهَا فَيُفِّكُمْ تَجْتَبْخَلُوا وَيُفْرِدْ أَضْغَانَكُمْ. If He were to ask you of it and press you, you would stingily, covetously hold it, and He will bring out all your secrets. Behold, you are those who are called to spend in the cause of Allah. فَمِنْكُمْ مَنْ يَبْخَلْ وَمَنْ يَبْخَلْ فَإِنَّمَا يَبْخَلُ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ. Yet among you are some who are niggardly, and whoever is niggardly, it is only at the expense of his own self. وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِي وَأَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَى. Allah says, وَاللَّهُ الْغَنِي. Allah is rich. He's free from all that. وَأَنْتُمُ الْفُقَرَى. And we are in need. We are the poor. We are the fuqara. We are also asked to give that which is best and that which is dearest. As Allah says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِنْ طَيِّبَاتِ مَا كَسَبْتُمْ. O you who believe, spend of the good things which you have legally earned. وَمِمَّا أَخْرَجْنَا لَكُمْ مِنَ الْأَرْضِ. and of that which you have produced from the earth for you. وَلَا تَتَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ. And do not aim at that which is bad to spend from it. وَلَسْتُمْ بِآخِذِهِ إِلَّا أَن تُغْمِضُوا فِيهِ وَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ غَنِيٌّ حَمِيدٌ. Though you would not accept it save if you close your eyes and tolerate therein. It's a very important ayah. وَلَا تَتَيَمَّمُوا الْخَبِيثَ مِنْهُ تُنْفِقُونَ. And do not aim at that which is bad. In other words, don't go into transactions and make haram money. You know, people want to acquire, go into drugs, go to Grand West, and then they make niyyah, inshallah, I hit the jackpot, I can hajj. Yeah. I've had this case of people coming to me already. Where a guy hit the jackpot, he said, Imam Market School for me, two cases I had like that, about 10, 15 years ago. Ik zei van Kalani Jik en die surf. How can you? Do you know how people use the shuyukh and the ulama? And they go from phone call to phone call. I get it. They probably come to me last different case, I get a different answer. It doesn't work that way, my brother. Allah protects us from that. In order to make things halal, which is haram. وَالْحَرَامُ بَيِّنْ وَالْحَلَالُ بَيِّنْ. Whatever is haram will stay haram. Whatever is halal, Allah has made halal, don't make it haram. Be very careful. We also have to seek the worthy and the deserving people. And here we have a few categories. We should look for the pious people who have renounced the world. Give it to them. Go look for them. They won't put their hands out. They won't go to the societies, they won't come to you and ask. You have to go look for them. Secondly, the person who is looking for ilm, who's on the path of knowledge, go look for them and support them. Thirdly, the one who is in need and keeps his neediness for himself, and he doesn't want to complain and doesn't want to fuss. Just this morning I met somebody. Yeah, I'm meeting in the gym, Allah initiate this. And this lady has been chucked into Cape Town just like that, and she's from Durban, taking the kids away. She's diabetic and she needs money. We have to help people like that. This is how we have to help people. And they are shy to come forward. Somebody else had to tell me about this person. Just to give an example, there are so many in our community like that. There is another, where there's someone who has a large family, or he's disabled, or the illnesses, or whatever cause. And the fifth recipient should be a close relative, whether it's paternal or maternal. We're not speaking about zakat to be given to your father, to your children, no. We are starting with the Dhawil Qurba. Remember early on, we spoke about, start with your family first. And we have to consider this. The Quran speaks about the eligible, those who are eligible to receive zakat. In the masadaqat al fuqara'i wal masakin wal amilin alayha wal mu'allafati qulubuhum wa fi riqab wal amil wal ghamirin wa fi sabilillahi wa ibnis sabil fariidatan min Allah wallahu alimul hakim. Allah says in the Quran, zakat are only for the fuqara, the poor, the masakin, the destitute, and those employed to collect the funds. And to attract the hearts of those who have been inclined towards Islam, and to free the captives, and for those in debt, and for Allah's cause, those fighting in the holy battle, and for the traveler who is cut off from everything, a duty imposed by Allah, and Allah knows all of that. We have to understand we cannot pay zakat to our dependents who depend on us. Don't use look for loopholes. We get these calls time and again. Imam, can I give my wife? Is this so lekker? It's one of our. Some say this must so. But be very careful. Those that you're supposed to support and maintain, zakat is not for them. This includes your wife, your parents, your grandparents, eldest living grandparents, children and grandchildren, right down to the great-great-grandchildren. These are the ones you cannot give. And what is your basic needs? Because people ask these questions and look for loopholes. Basic needs refer to the things one cannot do without. And by that we mean big screen TV. You smile. You see, sometimes we have this warped sense of idea, I can't do without a TV, or I can't do without this, and I can't do without this. These are luxuries. We cannot go into these kind of things. Food, clothing, housing, transportation for oneself and one's dependents. It includes your spouse and your children who are unable to earn the living, and the parents who are in need. Have I said enough? I have. Another question that comes up, what if I have debt? Should I exclude that from the amount which I have to pay zakat? Go to your various societies, they will explain to you in detail. I'm giving you an overview. If your payback is in the immediate future, you have to look at it this way. If the debt is due in the very near future at the time of paying zakat, this debt can be excluded from the amount of zakat. If it's a long-term payback arrangement, like we say installment basis, then the amount that has already been paid of the previous lunar year is subtracted from the total income in the processing of your zakat. No kan alla bli med fond nu, men man lär explain det ju för att det. Att med fond har vi. The other question that comes, do women have to pay zakat on jewelry? It's always, you know, fighting and concepts. Some say that zakat is due on the type of jewelry, some say yes, some say no. And the hadith have been given. Sa'id ibn al-Musayyib, Sa'id ibn al-Jubayr, Mujahid, and Imam Abu Hanifa, radiallahu anhum, they say you have to pay zakat on gold jewelry. On the other hand, Tawus, Imam Malik, Ash-Sha'bi, Imam Ash-Shafi'i, Imam Ahmad, all the other Imams, in other words, except Imam Abu Hanifa, are all of the opinion that you don't have to pay zakat on gold jewelry. Now I need to make a point of departure here. When you hoard jewelry for saving purposes, so it can grow in investment, you must pay on that gold. But jewelry that you wear, if you have 10 gold watches and so forth, all these kind of things, you don't have to pay zakat on that. We have to be careful that Allah assist us, that we implement the concept of zakat. Remember Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq after the demise of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He went to war to go collect the zakat. That's how the situation. If we had just have to give zakat, subhanAllah, that's all. Just give our zakat. I don't think we would have had poor Muslims in this part of the world. And then go an extra step, give sadaqah. So Allah can remove the bala from oneself and from us as a community, we would be in a better place, Ya Allah. So may Allah open our eyes, inshaAllah, bi'idhnillah, that we pay our zakat on time. If you want to pay advanced zakat, you're allowed even to do that. That's how far you can go. This masjid won't accept zakat except for the teachers. You're allowed to give zakat for people that are teaching. So you're welcome to give in that form, for example. May Allah in His mercy bless you and forgive me.